Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 7 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night. We actually go 7.5 hours a day, folks, because my son Tom started a new show today, Morning Market Kickoff, 8:30 in the morning. So join us at 8:30 in the morning. Don't make assumptions. Ask for what you want. Find the courage to ask for what you want. Others have the right to tell you yes or no, but you always have the right to ask. Likewise, everyone has the right to ask you for what they want, and you have the right to say yes or no. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials right now down $1.40, Nasdaq off 13, S&P's flat, gold contract trading down $3 at $15.57 an ounce. You got silver down 28 cents, $17.79 an ounce. Light sweet crude, $58.34 a barrel. Notes and bonds. Note and bond market, you get the 10-year up 16 ticks, trading 129.18. The 30-year up a full point plus 9 ticks at 158.18. And King Dollar. King Dollar down 54 ticks, trading 97.552. The euro is at 110. The yen is out here at 109.83, and the pound is at 130 to 1 U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? Well, if we start with the SPY, folks, what you're going to see is this. Is that what you had on Friday? All the indices went to highs, had volume behind the move. Bottom line out here today, what you're doing, you're going up and testing the indices again. You're not going to have the volume behind the move out here. We got an hour left in the market. If we take a look at the SPY, what you're going to see, it's pretty incredible, actually, what happened with the SPY, that it actually tested it to the penny. And we're talking about a numerical number of $332.18. So it's pretty wild. We did 95 million shares on Friday. Bottom line, you're at 52 million today. We'll do another 15 million or something. Get up to about 65. And we tested the high. Bottom line is that right now you're at 331.64. NDX 100, same type of setup inside the NDX 100 we did there. NDX 100 on Friday got up to the price point of 223.56. We hit 223.84 out here. We'll see whether it can close over it. It's not going to have the volume. It's not going to be as contracted as the S&P. Right now, we're at 16 million. The NQs have done, or the 3Qs have done, they're going into 24 million. That'll probably do about 18. Small caps still can't handle it. It's pretty amazing, actually. IWM. Had the high on Friday, off this high, not heavy volume off the high, but the bottom line, you're off the high. You're at the IWM's down $1.50. You're $1.14 rather. You're at 167.93, and you need to come down almost another dollar in order to get inside that lower range. Gold contract up here. Let's go take a look at the gold contract. What do you have with the gold contract out here? Bottom line, monster volume. You have a market that's down $3.30. We had a high today of 1568. We had a low of 1546. We're trading 1556. Now, this is going to be really wild watching this thing shake out. The reason being is this. So, on the 8th of January, folks, that's when metals, currencies, S&Ps, everything had quite a violent move. What happened inside the metal market is that we went to $1,613. You had 813,000 contracts, monster contract volume, and it didn't hold price. What you had done there is that you had taken out the B point of an ABC structure on the way up. And when you close under that B point, it goes from a confirmed ABC structure up to a complex ABC structure up. What a complex one means is this. Is that, and this is on the way up or the way down. A complex one on the way up is that you take your B point out, you take it out with volume, you give it up on price. In order to keep that a complex one, what you do next is that you pull back with light volume. That's exactly what the gold contract did. Went up with 813,000 contracts, comes back with 373,000, comes back with 341. And then what does it do again? Bottom line, starts taking off again with volume. That's what we've done out here today. This is going to go after the B point again. The B point out here is 1590, And this ABC structure on the way up has a potential, has a price projection of 1704. So I expect we're going to get some good action in the metals market. And if we go over and we take a look at the note and bond market, you're going to see why. Bottom line, the note and bond market folks continue to want higher price, lower yield. And when you get that, guess what? Lower interest rates are, the more juice they can give inside the metals market. Bottom line, the 30-year right now has an expansion of volume. The 30-year on the 8th of January got to a price point of 159.19. We're only a point below that right now for the 30-year. The 30-year can move in point increments very easy. Bottom line, you get the expansion of volume happening. It's all there. This 30-year looks to me like it wants to go to 164. So going to be a lot of action out here. Dollar index. What do we have with the dollar index? Dollar index, bottom line, big countertrend move last week. Bottom line, you know, last 2 weeks actually. We hit down to 96.355. Right now you're at 97.552. That being said, what you have not done is that you have not broken the downtrend when we went from an uptrend to a downtrend the first week in December. The dollar index from February of, there she is right there. One, two, three, let's do it this way. There she is. So from February of 2018, the first week of December, bottom line, that broke the downtrend with conviction. What you have up here is that in order to basically get inside, well, to get inside the uptrend once again, you'd have to get to 98.450. So you need just about another penny or 900 ticks from where we are right now. And it doesn't look to me that that's going to go there. And what we did have out here last week, and that's why the dollar can get some traction, is that if we take a look at the euro, you're going to see the euro had backed down. Bottom line, we backed down from the 112 level. Right now you're at the 110 level. The pound had also backed down. The differential with the pound now is that the pound is starting to go topside once again. Right now we're at 130.47 inside the pound. That baby, you know, this off the lows just somewhat, but it looks like the pound wants to go to this 135. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.